Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are back in Circuit Superstars. There's been a couple updates since I've last done a video on this. Got two new cars. We got the Pacino. Hey. We also have the new Vost rally car. So we'll be taking a look at both of these, but we're going to start off with the Pacino today. Let's get into a race. All right. Oh, look at all the wonderful liveries we got here. We got Tilk Sport. We're going to do 10 laps, get some pitting in, and discussing how the new car do. I've gone for more of the Italian flag livery. I like the little checkered flag down there. That's cool. So yeah, the Pacino handles really well. It has a front wheel drive characteristic, and that it pushes wide into corners. You can kind of oversteer it. That's just kind of how the game is. If you go into a corner a little too fast, it'll just plow, go wide. Oh, getting wild back there. It's not the fastest thing in the world, but it handles very, very good. Gotta remember how the course go. Ride that candy cane. Into our qualifying lap now. Coming around the hairpin. Yeah, if you just gun it into in the corner, you'll kind of go wide. Ah! Coming up the end of our qualifying lap here. Across the line. And there's the standings. Nice first pole position. Into the race we shall go. Tilk Sport, 10 laps. Let's get into it. Fun fact, if you rev your car at the start, you use fuel. Go first couple corners, feeling pretty good. Along with the sort of pushy front-wheel drive nature of this car, you would think it'd be really twitchy, but it actually is very linear in its steering. By that I mean it's smooth. Sliding wide, oh, totally missing the apex there. Oh, nice. I gotta admit, I haven't been spending as much time in this game as I thought I was going to be, but don't let that put you off. This is a very, very fun game. I just have a bunch of others that I'm always playing, and if I got any spare time, I'll try and hop on, do a couple races in here. The things I would like to see kind of in the future would be a little more comprehensive experience ladder, or like when you finish the race, you'll see the numbers. They don't really mean anything to me. I don't know what 5,000 is, you know, and leveling up kind of seems to be a grind. It's okay. I don't know what I'm working for next, you know, what's in the next level, or, you know, when do I unlock this? Is it random? That would be something to kind of tweak. Maybe at some point, maybe a livery editor altogether. But that's just small things down the line. They're still working on smoothing the game out, making it more optimized, making the online better. They're working on console versions. They're busy, and it's cool to see that they do weekly updates with new online racing modes and time trials. Good to see that they're doing that. A lot of game developers will release a promising game and then just kind of sit. Low fuel. I think we can make one more lap after this, and then we'll go into the pits. But with this handling, you'll notice I'm just kind of throwing it into corners. I'm using a lot of my tires, so being smoother, you can hear him screaming away. Being smoother will warrant better tire wear and fuel consumption. I'm literally just hammering gas, hammering brake, hammering gas, hammering brake. But this game does want you to be a little more finesse than that. I have it on pro difficulty, which in the past has been actually a little more difficult. I think they've kind of lightened that up. Maybe I'm just getting better. In the next race with the rally car, we will up the difficulty. But hopefully we can make this lap without running out of fuel. Ooh. The track looking as good as always with that sweet, sweet design. By design, I mean tire wear. The tire marks in the track. I can't get over it. It just looks so cool. And in my admiration for the track design, I'm going off course. Just rambling to myself, waiting for the pits. We are dangerously low on fuel. Oh, fudge popsicles. Haha. Oh, and we did that. That's awesome. Coming into the pits. Yes, I know I'm out of fuel. But we can do exactly 5 laps. Give me some tires, give me some fuel, and away we go. Fresh tires and a fresh start of life. Whoa! They've also been adding more little anti-cheat, if you will. Can't cut as many corners as you used to be able to. Coming up on him. Ooh! Little contact. Going for the undercut. Gotta stay in. He's going for it. Oh, yeah. And that's a position. Another feature that might help a little bit for newer players and more casual. This is a pretty casual game, but, you know, new players would be some sort of like a suggested racing line. I know the tire wear on the track is kind of letting you know, like, hey, here's where people brake and turn in. But when you can't really see the corner coming up due to the camera angle nature, it would be kind of nice to have like maybe a little warning before a corner after a long straightaway, like, hey, you should probably brake now, like right here. Like, I always miss the apex because I don't know really where to stop, start braking. Just, you know, with more time in the game and more gameplay, you'll figure it out. But just kind of like a little tutorial, little help you, a little training wheel. Yeah, training wheels is what I wanted to say. A little training wheel exercise. But as we get late into the race and almost wrapping things up, it is a good time to promote the Twitch channel, Drunkbox_Supreme, on the screen. Check it out. Last lap, low fuel. Back to the Twitch thing. I couldn't figure out the words I wanted to say. I stream whenever I can. And I usually stream like American Truck Sim, Car X, Drift Racing Online. You can come drift with me. Come hang out. And some 5M here and there. Lately I've been addicted to this Busted server, which is like just one guy that runs and then everyone else is a cop. It's so, so fun. It's just ridiculous, you know, everyone rams each other and it's just a great, great time. So if you want to do that as well, come on, stop by and hang out. But here we go, final couple corners. Into the last straight, riding the candy cane! Boom! That's a winner right there, folks. And a look at the new Pacino. You see the experience here? Like, XP? It doesn't even say XP, it just says, here's numbers that you get. Another fun little update I think that would be cool to this game is with every podium screen like this, have it, unique to the track. That's just like way, way down the line if they're bored. Hey, here's the other new vehicle, the Vost. Let's do a race with that. So alongside with the Vost, there is a new track, Buffalo Hill. This one's been out for a little bit now. And I actually, in testing this morning, I was trying out the Pacino at this track, and it does all right, but the AI has no idea what to do. Oh, and I said I was gonna up the difficulty and I forgot. Damn it. Oh well. And you guys are gonna enjoy me absolutely ruining these fools as I make a fool of myself. But these handles so much different. The acceleration is crazy. You can oversteer it. And it'll spin out. Coming into our qualifying lap here, hit the apron there. You got to be a lot more gentle with the throttle. If you just punch it, it'll just spin and you'll end up losing speed. Hitting the jump. Oh yeah. You know, the Pacino actually hit that jump very well. It did all right. Coming up. Oh, it's another pole position. I was gonna say first place. I like this track. It's nice and simple. It's fast paced. This would be a good one to have online at all times. The Crazy Rally. All right, let's go. Revving your car uses fuel. Good launch. Try not to get rammed. And that's the last time we see these guys. Bye! Over the jump. Coming around the dirt. I like this corner a lot. First lap of the race in. I found with the dirt surfaces, the AI is actually easier to defeat. That's why I really wanted to up the difficulty. But yeah, you'll see here, I just pull away. In future updates too, with like livery editor, whatever the hell I'm talking about. Track editor. Oh man, there's the spinning out I was talking about. A sandbox mode, like, or a map. A big open, just exploration map would be really cool too. Kind of like Art of Rally, but not. Just something a little more. The tracks are really nice. But if we had the option to create our own racetracks and host a server of like, hey, here's my recreation of this track, or here's my crazy design that I came up with. That would add a lot more to this game, I feel. How are we doing on tires? Okay. Spinning out, this is a learning curve. Every car is different and they handle very different. You gotta keep it flat around the dirt there. Nice big sweeping turns into hairpins. Oh man, you idiot, dude. That'll happen. Remember when I was like, oh, here's the last time we're gonna see these guys. Haha. Recording brings on a whole new wave of shit. But it looks like we can do one or two more laps before we have to pit. I'm gonna do just one more lap in pit, and that'll basically secure our position. I'd be curious too, these developers have done a very fine job with this camera mode, and the top down. I wonder what it would be like if you could modify it, or if they would implement sort of a chase camera. You know, a third person, not top down. How different would... Oh, shit, I was gonna pit. How... Damn it. How different would this game be? How much different would it feel? Alright, not forgetting to go into the pits. Let's murder some pit crew. That's what you guys get. And stopping. Give me fuel, give me tire, give me all that I desire. Oh. Yeah! There's no way that these guys didn't pit yet, right? Oh. That was good. Over the jump! This game looks so good. I hope the recording shows how good this game is. Yeah, it's good cheap fun too. Now it's on Steam for like 17 bucks, you and a couple friends hang out. It's got split screen. The online's pretty decent. There was a little latency issues here and there, but you know, in due time. Coming up on the inside. Oh, we're getting side by side. He goes around. Coming up to the last lap. That was our best. Oh, our best lap, too. Going around town, Squidward. Yeah, he had to feather the throttle around those sharper turns because the car just wants to spin. Jumping over the hill for the last time. Hitting the big twisty. Man, imagine if they did rally stages. That'd be sick. And across the line. And we have leveled up, I do believe. Another victory in the books. There's our Ken Block inspired machine. Oh, we did get got the new design. Awesome. Hell yeah. As far as designs too, they also added a new design for this. I believe this is new. They added two new designs for this, and it says which you might unlock. So with the XP thing I was talking about earlier, everything I think you unlock is random. It just chooses like, you get this today. So we get this now, which colors actually work pretty good. Yeah. So there it is, guys. Tell me what you thought of Circuit Superstars. Do you play it? Do you enjoy it? Should we stream it sometime? I don't know. Let me know. Like the video if only you like this video. Comment down below. Tell me what you want to see, what you want to hear, what you want me to do with my life. And as always, consider subscribing for more of this horribly good content as I stumble my way out of this video. Thank you, guys. Goodbye.